with that question, again, that proves that first point about her discernment. So what is it that you've done that attract these type of men?
So I think that the next question that I need to ask Empress, what have you done to ensure that you do not attract these type of men again? What have you learned?
I've been just keeping to myself, reading more, you know, just trying to get myself mentally together.
Hold on. How are you keeping to yourself if you have a husband?
Yeah, I'm about to just actually.
Things that make you go,
doing his own thing.
Don't blow my spot now.
No, I'm just asking questions, man. Empress, I'm trying to help out, man. I'm not pulling up no spots, man.
The hot seat.
What's that?
You got me on the hot seat.
Nah, man, I'm just, you know.
Don't even.
Nah, man.
I'm waiting for the one you said I do to. I'm waiting for him to pop up. Where he at?
He ain't so nice.
he's on his time. He runs the show.
No.
Oh, you run. No, she run the show.
Not with this one. He's more serious. He's serious.
You gotta have a little humor in there, Empress. It's essential.
Okay, look, I'm a Virgo. He's a Scorpio. So yeah, if y'all know,
we don't do that over here. We don't get into the astrology and all of that.
It matters though.
No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't. See, that's probably a part of your relationship right there. Huh? Yeah, that's one of the problems you got having in your relationships.
Go.
You allowing someone to predetermine what someone is supposed to behave like.
No. Like I said, it's from experience.
Yeah, but when you read that, you already you're gonna develop a certain mindset, and you're gonna anticipate certain things from people instead of really getting to see the true person.
Yeah,
you're gonna what's your sign? Now you're trying to analyze it. Real sick.
I give everybody a chance. You show me who you are. Even though I'm into astrology and all that stuff, I let you show me who you are.
See?
I let you show you who you are.
But you believe that those signs determine the person's characteristics, though, right?
Not fully, because the environment plays a part in that, too. How they were raised and stuff like that. So it's not just based on the horoscope. It's how you was raised, your environment, you know, your childhood.
Prejudging.
All of that stuff. So it's not just the horoscope. It's everything. I put everything there.
Yeah.
All right. But how long do you wait to have sexual intercourse before you know the person's background, childhood? How long do you do that? You have the sex first or after?
I have not. I should have been doing that, getting a list. I should have got my list out and be like, or else I wouldn't be in the mess I've been in. I should have had my list.
Yeah. So
kids got?
Huh?
There's too many people with too many questions, man.
I gotta get my charger. My iPad, and I can't, my laptop is not letting
me. Hey, Robin. Let me go back to Robin. Yeah. What do you think about what she's saying here?
I can relate with her when it comes to.
Nah, Robin, keep it real. Be Robin. Listen, Robin, you change up your game now. Be Robin. Yeah. You heard her basically saying, from what I'm hearing, Robin, her body count is pretty high.
I need your expert opinion.
Oh, I
never
I think
said
she's young. You're a young girl. You're a young girl, and I have.
She never said her age yet, Robin.
Huh?
She never said her age yet, Robin.
Well,
I'm 44.
So she's not a young girl. You see that, Robin?
I'm 44.
She's not a young girl.
Oh my God. Okay. So I agree with you about, like, they literally, like, people in general, they gain your trust for so long, and then boom.
Nah, Robin, you talk all of this stuff about women. Okay, since nobody, let me tell you guys something, man. I don't like how you guys are talking, man, because you guys usually talk like men, but now tonight, you're talking real soft, man. Maybe she does. Maybe she is real charismatic with you guys. So you guys are not coming across like you normally come across. So just listen and let me question her. Now, let me ask you this.
Yes.
Let me ask you this. And Robin, you're not even talking that talk. You was talking real greasy about until she came on,
Robin. Women are all like, I feel so bad for my son because I know his heart's going to be broken because he's going to have a string of hoes. And I hope he doesn't turn to anything like destructive because that's just the way it is these days.
I'll never go back on that.
I'm saying, but she did admit that she had sex before she even got to know these guys fully, right? You know, and that's what my point was that. That's what people don't do.
People don't value their own temple anymore.
I'm gonna kick everyone out of the room because I can't get the ask to the questions. Because everyone's like, oh, yeah, 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 no structure. See, you guys are being light on her. And the more that I probe, the more that I ask questions, more keeps coming out that she wasn't revealing in the beginning. You see what I'm saying? And you bear witness to that, Kadar. The right kind of questions is getting her first, you know, the men, you know. What part of responsibility are you going to assume for, you know, gravitating towards all these bad men? Okay, after the first couple times, you know that men or women will reveal them true selves in the beginning. So you're supposed to wait that out and see what happens. Well, I know what happened the last time. So this is why I'm saying, what did you learn to ensure that this doesn't happen again?
The logic.
Yeah, what is she doing that prevents this from happening again in the future?
Arkin, that's why I asked her. I said that, do you have the sex before you got to know the person's childhood background? And she said, yeah, she had the sex first. And then afterwards, she got to know the person and realized this was the wrong guy. That's what people do. People will engage in the lust first before they get to know the person, and then like, oh, this guy, he ain't nothing, she ain't it. And that's the problem. That's the problem, though. And she admitted it. You know what I'm saying? So that's what, she's wrong in that situation, because you didn't fully evaluate the person before you spread your legs for them. And now you already bonded with the man, and now you're not getting the man you thought she was going to get when you open your legs for him, and now he becomes the person that, oh, he's no good. But it's really you that's no good, because you're the one that didn't evaluate the person before that. So now you feel ashamed of yourself that you gave your body to this person before you evaluated them, and now you want to still blame the man for that, though. She wrong for that, though. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I don't detect that she felt any shame. What I'm hearing is a lot of anger. I'm able to develop
and regret.
What I'm hearing is a lot of anger towards men, because if I didn't mention women, I don't think any of that would have actually come up. I was like, well, you know, there's women that is toxic and so on and so forth. If you go back and you listen to this call, she was really coming at men like how bad they are, and you know, got to take care of them, and they're toxic, and a lot of them don't know how to raise children. So I'm saying, what about women?
Okay.
Yeah.
Can I cook clean. Like, I was like, oh, I don't cook every night. Like, I was like, well, she sounds like a good woman. I kind of, you know, that's what I was thinking. Like, she seemed sweet, smiling. And
I see through all of that, Robin. See, I was listening. I wasn't listening with emotions. I was listening to it. Was being said, but then I was listening to all of the derogatory terms towards these men. And so what part of responsibility are you willing to assume, you know, from this? Can I add it to the call?
The professional. Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
That chair that you have back, can you help us a little bit about that? That's a beautiful chair, man. I mean, beautiful.
Oh yeah, it's a king's chair, man. Malak.
That's a beautiful chair, man. Sorry,
hey, D, observe it. Well, he's observant.
Yeah. Hey, Empress, tell her to go out and come back in. Her device is not connected.
come.
You know, and she's an educated lady, which is also, you know, just kind of like, it makes me believe that maybe she's thinking with her heart and not with her head at that point.
Empress, you got to go out and come back in. Your device is not connected. This is what I'm going to say. This is what I've learned. The more educations a lot of these women have, the more of a problem they usually are. If we was to talk to some of these men, I know for a fact that a lot of the stuff that she's saying, I don't think it would stand like that. I'm able to discern this. I sit back and I listen. Now, she knew that these men was in this condition when she met them. That's why I asked, which part of responsibility are you willing to assume in the way these things didn't work? You know, where's your discernment right here? Why would you engage these kind of men if you know ultimately they're like this? You may not know it in the beginning, but if you're a patient and you don't spread your quiver, you'll get to see the true person come out. If you court them for a while, instead of just rushing into it. You see what I'm saying? So you can't, you know, this is what I want to say to guys, man. And Robin, you kind of switch yours up a little bit. You can't, because someone comes on talking nice and sweet.
Yeah.
You got to really listen to what they're really saying. And that's what I was doing. Right. I listened to what's really being said.
In the beginning, it was, then she said cooking, cleaning, and I'm a good, like everything was just good about her. And I looking back.
Just the beginning.
Yeah, but the beginning, it was like all negative about men.
When someone is talking all negative about someone else, you have to ask, okay, what did you do wrong?
Yep.
And see how they answer that.
They'll always make the other person look bad.
But where did you go wrong? Well, okay, let's say this person was really messed up. Which part of the responsibility are you willing to assume for making a bad decision and inviting this effed up person into your life?
And she said first that she don't leave no man. She didn't leave no man. They said they all left her at first, she said. And then at the end, when Kadar asked her the question, she said, oh yeah, I left them. She said that.
She never got cheated on.
She said that. No, but she said that they left her. She never said she left them. At the end, when Kadar asked her the question about,
can anyone,
so why these men leave you? She said,
she's back. Time out. She's back.
Yeah.
I was trying to
set up.
My laptop and my phone is not clicking on. It's just my iPad and it's on the charger 3%. Yeah, so I am not trying to down talk anyone. I'm just telling my experiences, and I've been, and I'm still a good woman. I've been with the wrong men, the wrong boys, I should say, not men.
Naughty boys, man.
Okay, again, Empress, let's just step outside for a second. Huh?
Yeah.
We're going to deal with no emotions right here. Huh?
Okay, no emotions.
So think about this, right?
Mm-hmm.
You have a choice in this matter, right?
Yes.
So what you're really supposed to do before you, especially if you're established the way that you said you were, right?
Mm-hmm.
Before you allow just anyone into your life, you're supposed to evaluate them.
Yes. Check them out. Definitely.
Be a little patient and see how, because I agree to what you said when you said people never come on as themselves. They always have on a costume in the beginning,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And again, I agree with when you say they think they got you, then the true person comes out.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where you got to kind of like fill it out before, you know, you really, because I'm going to tell you how men think, right? Once a man have sex with a woman, he's feel as though he's conquered her,
mm-hmm,
because there's nothing else more valuable that she can really offer him than herself.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So he believes that, okay, well, I conquered her. Now all of the air has actually been let out of the balloon. And so now he believes he has certain, because let's face it, once a man has sex with a woman once, the next time's always easier. Because there's been an exchange of body fluids and there's some sort of bond.